Greetings, folks. T-Mott back again for another drive time. I'm sitting down here with the brothers. I often come down here and I talk with them about what's going on in politics, et cetera, et cetera. Well, I happen to meet a young man today that is a brother of some gentlemen, his older brothers that I went to school with. One of his brothers, William Hill, is a lawyer in Atlanta, Georgia, has a prominent law firm. You can look him up. It is important that I tell this story so you know that I'm not pulling your leg. I'm going to show you his face. I'm going to tell you the story that he told me. His name is Teddy Hill. Teddy, just say hello.
How you doing?
All right. Essentially, back in, 87. Teddy had a friend that tried to rob him. Do you mind? Teddy had a friend that tried to rob him. In the process of trying to defend himself, Teddy was shot 3 times with a shotgun blast. Passed out. However, when the police arrived, that was at the moment that he was coming to. When he came to, not knowing if it was the original assailants coming back to finish the job, he pulled his weapon and he fired, shooting a police officer. They did not identify themselves. That's the point that I want to make here. But let me tell you what happened next, which is symptomatic of what I have been saying about politicians allowing bad cops to persist. These were two white officers. We're talking 1987, before the advent of cell phones, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, and videos going viral, exposing a lot of the things that happened behind the scenes. Do you mind? Do you mind? Thank you. I know what you're doing, but can you please give me an opportunity to tell this story out of respect? Thank you very much, brother. I really appreciate it. Okay, thank you. So when the two police officers came and Teddy fired at the police officer, I understand that the police officers wanted to defend themselves. But here is to the extent of which they did that. The police officer, the one that was hit, after he fell, the other officers went up to Teddy, who was barely conscious, put the gun to his head. Teddy, in defense, a defensive move, put his arm up, was shot through his arm into his head in an attempt to kill him. He rolled over and the officer shot him 3 more times. But here's where it gets interesting. When the paramedics came, because Teddy wisely decided to play dead, the paramedics arrived, he rolled over, and the white cop said, "Damn, that nigga ain't dead yet." This is what I'm talking about. And to add insult to injury, the prosecutor said to him, "Sir, can you allow me to tell the story? Please. I understand that, but your back talk is interfering. So I've asked you respectfully." Thank you. So the prosecutors said, "Tell you what, if you don't press charges against the cops because they didn't follow procedures, we won't press charges against you for attempted murder on a police officer." And of course, without counsel, without proper and wise counsel, because they even admitted that they did not follow proper police procedures, Teddy Hill, Mr. Teddy Hill, decided not to press charges and just let the matter drop. But this has been a systemic problem with politicians allowing bad cops to remain on the force. And I told you this all goes back to 1967, right after the 64 Civil Rights Act and the 65 Voting Rights Act, when they gave us the qualified immunity for police officers in 1967. And that was a reason for that. T-Mott out, drive time till next time. I just had to tell his story. Peace.